Hey, why do you look so down? I didn't really plan out what I was gonna say before I hit record, but I'm just gonna let it come to me. Yeah, this life is hard. You're gonna hit bumps in the road. It's guaranteed. People suck. Lots of people suck. People are gonna make you mad. People are gonna make you sad. People are gonna make you happy. People are gonna make you tired. The difference between somebody who fails and somebody who succeeds is how you react to it. See, you have the option to pick yourself back up and learn from your mistakes and not let those comments get to you, or let them get to you and completely give up. That's your choice. So what are you gonna do? What are you gonna do today? Are you gonna let them win?
Let me introduce you to this amazing website. You just type in openbible.info. It's gonna take you to this page. You're gonna press topical. You're gonna scroll down a little bit. It's gonna say, what does the Bible say about? You chose anxiety. You can type in love, money, anything like that. And it's gonna show you all the verses that talk about that particular topic that you chose. It's amazing. I use it all the time.
To wash the baby's hair.
Oil, right now. No, more. Buddy, this is apple juice.
We need all we can get. That would do.
You're right. Shake de le bo bo bo.
What you do not see in yourself, others see in you. You do matter.
I'm going to show you guys what you need to do every single week. Have a game plan. So what a game plan is and what I have started integrating in my relationship with God and my devotions is a game plan, which is basically goals for that week. So goal number one is morning devos, journal and read one chapters of Psalm per day. Another goal this week is to only listen to worship music. Another goal for me personally is to pray before I film and pray before I post. And my last goal is to do nighttime devotions and read one chapter of Proverbs per night. And I also wrote at the bottom of what prayer I'm gonna focus on this week. So I'm gonna pray for more opportunity to talk more about God. I'm praying that I'm focusing more on God throughout the day. And then I have one personal prayer that I'm not gonna share with you guys. Yeah, you need to do a game plan. It's so helpful, so helpful.
I don't know who needs to hear this, but God does not work the same way today that he did in Bible times.
There was a little girl named Jenny who had cancer. The doctor gave her 6 weeks to live. The church came and prayed over her. Somehow, some way, the cancer began disappearing. It was a medical miracle. The doctor told her that because she had so much radiation damage, she would never be able to have kids. And even in the slightest chance that she did get pregnant, she would either miscarriage or her children would have a lot of deformities and special needs. Jenny is my mom. She has 3 healthy kids. The only issue I have is asthma. The fact that I even exist is living proof that God still works today. I don't know what your church has been teaching you, but God absolutely still works miracles today. I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for prayer. I think the church needs to stop telling God what he can and can't do.
Revelation! So I've been in my study of Mark recently. I literally just started today. And I just read this verse when Jesus was asked by a Pharisee, why do your disciples not fast? Fast forward to 22, he says, and no man puts new wine into old bottles, else the new wine does burst the bottles, and the wine is spilt, and the bottles will be marred, but new wine must be put into new bottles. When God gives you that Holy Spirit, that new wine, it can't dwell in an old temple, a temple full of sin, a temple full of lust, a temple that's still worldly, because that Spirit that is in you now from God, it will start grieving and it will leave. And then the anointing, the blessing, the power will be gone. So we have to constantly be putting to death our fleshly man and allowing our temple to be holy for God. Allowing our temple to be pure. The Spirit cannot dwell with sin. So be new.
God isolates you so you can get yourself together. It may seem like you lost friendships and relationships, but a better you is worth so much more.
God has perfect timing. Never early, never late. It just takes a little patience and a whole lot of faith, but it's worth the wait. God's plans is always the best. Sometimes the process is painful and hard, but But don't forget that when God is silent, He's doing something for you. Sometimes, God closes doors because it's time to move forward. You see, He knows you won't move unless your circumstances force you to. God answers all prayers in three ways. Yes, because you deserve it. No, because you deserve better. And not yet, because the best is yet to come.
Even the comatose, they don't dance until...
Why do I love God? 'Cause when He loves me, I feel like I'm floating. When He calls me chosen, I feel like somebody with purpose. He changed me, I'm a new creation. He will always be my favorite form of loving. That's why.
I believe in God.